हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम प्रेम प्रकाश शुक्ला, योर मैथमेटिक्स टीचर फ्रॉम एलपीएम पब्लिक स्कूल। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न द टॉपिक सॉल्विंग इक्वेशंस बाय यूजिंग ट्रांसपोजिशन मेथड। हाउ वी कैन सॉल्व इक्वेशन बाय यूजिंग ट्रांसपोजिशन मेथड, टुडे वी विल लर्न अबाउट इट। एंड दिस टॉपिक इज टेकन फ्रॉम चैप्टर 12, सो सॉल्विंग इक्वेशंस बाय ट्रांसपोजिशन मेथड। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल व्हाट वी हैव टू डू इज we have to isolate variable in this method, and next one is when the terms are transposed from one side of the equation to another side of the equation, the opposite operations are carried out. So the first thing is we have to isolate variable in this method, and then when the terms or numerical terms are transposed from one side of the equation to another side of the equation, the opposite operations are carried out. That means if there is addition, in one side of the equation, then addition is changed into subtraction on the other side of the equation. In the same way, subtraction is changed into addition. In the same way, multiplication is changed into division, and the division is changed into multiplication. So the process is when we transpose the terms from one side of the equation to another side of the equation, the opposite operations are carried out. That means if addition is present in one side of the equation, then it is changed into subtraction on the other side of the equation. In the same way, if subtraction is present in one side of the equation, then it is changed into addition. In the same way, if multiplication is present in one side of the equation, it is changed into division, and if division is present in one side of the equation, then it is changed into multiplication in the other side of equation. So by following this process, we can solve equations by this transposition method. So Now let's take some examples. Which will make us clear how transposition method works in solving the equations. So first of all, we take example one. Example one, x plus 3 equals to 7. So an equation is given, that is x plus 3 equals to 7, and we have to solve this equation by using transposition method. So here you see the numerical term 3. We have to transpose 3 to the other side of the equation, as well as the sign addition will be changed into subtraction to the other side of the equation. So x equals to 7 minus 3. This plus sign is changed into minus sign. That means transpose 3 and change the sign plus to minus, that is addition to subtraction. So now what we will get? If we subtract 3 from 7, we will get 4 as our answer. So here the variable is isolated from this term. Yes, when we isolate variable, the numerical term 3 is transposed to another side of equation, and the sign carried by 3 is addition sign, and when we transpose 3 to the another side of equation, the addition sign will change into subtraction sign, and in this way we can solve the equation by using transposition method. Let's take another example. Example 2. That is 2y minus 5 equals to 9. So another equation is given, 2y minus 5 equals to 9. Here the numerical term 5 contains sign subtraction. So when we transpose 5 to other side of equation, then the subtraction sign will be changed into addition sign. That is 2y equals to 9 plus 5, which means transpose 5 and change sign subtract to addition, or minus to plus. Here you see the sign minus is changed to plus. So when we transpose the term, the operation carried by the term is changed into opposite operation. So now just we have to add 9 plus 5, that is 14. Now again we have to transpose 2 to the other side of the equation. So when we transpose 2, it will be changed into division. Here 2 is in multiplication. Now when we change the 2, or when we transpose 2 to the other side of the equation, it will change, the sign will change into division. So y equals to, when we isolate the variable, then it will change into division. So transpose 2 and change multiplication to division. So here we have to remove 14 from 2, that is 2 1 2 2 7 14. Now y equals to 7. So in this way we can solve equation by using transposition method. So in transposition method, the variable is isolated with the other terms, and the terms that are transposed from one side of the equation to another side will carry opposite operations. Just you see an example here. Now I think this method is clear to you all. So thank you very much for listening and watching the video. Thank you very much.